when we're talking about the river Suir and as it travels through Tipperary and through the valleys around Clonmel, we often forget that it's heavily influenced by geology. And this geology affects the flora and fauna of the region, the water quality, and the direction of the river flow. The mountains are made of old red sandstone. Ireland formed about 400 million years ago, and this sandstone formed as Ireland travelled over the 400 million years towards its present location. And the sand from these mountains compacted, and they gave us the old red sandstone we have today. We can see much of that sandstone being used in our major buildings around Tipperary. For example, in our courthouses, in the main guard in Clonmel, or the West Gate. But we also see the limestone that's used as lintels and windowsills and on pillars around old hotels. And even if you walk around Clonmel and look at the West Gate and the limestone pavements, you can still see fossil remnants from the oceans as Ireland formed. The limestone that we have was formed about 340 million years ago as Ireland moved from where South Africa is towards the equator. So when we were around the equator, Ireland was flooded by a very rich warm sea with lots of corals and sea creatures. And it's the buildup of those dead sea creatures and corals that gave us our limestone. And this limestone is the main underlying bedrock in the valleys around South Tipperary. And that's what gives us the Golden Veil. We get a rich pasture land. It's actually the richest pasture land in Europe. So it's no accident that we have a vibrant dairy producing farmland or agriculture. But we also have a very important equestrian industry, because the limestone, the calcium in it, is very good for the grass and is very good for building bones, as they say. But what's it got to do with the river, you might ask? Well, one of the reasons is it gives us the water quality. Water quality is very important, and it's becoming more and more important. We get much of our water now from groundwater resources, but in the future we may have to abstract water from rivers for our growing industry and our urban populations. So we need to really look after the quality of that water, and we need to look after the species that depend on that water. A unique feature about the River Suir is the course it takes across the landscape. It travels south until it reaches Newcastle in County Tipperary, and then does a U-turn and it heads back north again. It's one of the few rivers to do this. Then it turns east and it travels through Clonmel, Carrick and Suir, and eventually Waterford. Historically, we think now that the River Suir travels south to Newcastle and continued through the Ballinamult Gap to come out into the sea near Dungarvan, not Waterford, where it currently is. The reason we think that the River Suir travelled south as far as Newcastle and then had to do a U-turn is because the underlying limestone eroded. It was at a higher level, but it eroded down over thousands and millions of years. The river no longer could get through the old red sandstone of the Knockmealdown Mountains, and it had to take a course that brought it north again and then east until it followed along the limestone valley through Clonmel and onto Carrick and Suir and eventually into Waterford. And unless the river had done a U-turn at Newcastle and turned east, we wouldn't have a Clonmel and a Carrick and Suir and other small towns located where they are today.